Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hello children, how are you all? I hope you are pretty well and taking good care of your health. Alhamdulillah, in the previous session we finished our 4th class Islamic studies chapter 10. And today we start our 11th chapter of Islamic studies. That is Eid ul Adha. Children, how many Eids do you celebrate in a year? Yes, Allah has blessed us with two Eids. That's our Eid ul Fitr and Eid ul Adha. Eid ul Adha comes after 2 months and 9 days of Eid ul Fitr. We celebrate Eid ul Adha on the 10th of Zulhijjah. It is a festival of sacrifice and marks the end of Hajj. Its special feature is the sacrifice of an animal. It is offered in memory of twin sacrifices offered by Prophet Ibrahim a.s. and Ismail a.s. This celebration is to remember Prophet Ibrahim a.s. who was very obedient to Allah and was ready to sacrifice his most precious possession. When he was asked to sacrifice everything for Allah, he said yes to whatever Allah commanded to Ibrahim alayhi salam, including the life of his son Ismail alayhi salam. One day, Allah ordered to Ibrahim alayhi salam to sacrifice his son. But in the last moment, however, he was told to sacrifice a ram instead of Ismail alayhi salam. Eid ul Adha reminds us of the great sacrifice of Prophet Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam. This Eid lasts for 3 days. People usually sacrifice their animals mostly on first and second days, but in small number rarely on third day. People arrange parties and get together. This joy comes to an end on the third day of Eid. Eid is the most important festival of Muslims. An Eid day means a day of enjoyment and sharing happiness. They exchange gifts and greetings with each other. Muslims begin this day to by offering salah in mosques. Its special feature, however, is the animal sacrifice. Usually, people bring a goat or sheep or buffaloes to sacrifice in the memory of Hazrat Ibrahim a.s. and his son Ismail a.s. They distribute meat of these animals in 3 equal shares. One for needy poor people, other for relatives, and third for themselves. The act symbolizes their willingness to give up things that are of benefit to them or too close to their hearts in order to follow Allah's command. The Eid days are the days to remember and thank Allah while rejoicing. It brings delight to all Muslims of the world. They are the days to help the poor and the needy. Alhamdulillah children, we have successfully completed the learning of chapter 11 of Islamic studies of class 4th. Now, turn to the page number 33. Now we will start activity part. In our activity part, our first bit is answer these questions. Okay children, now get ready to answer my questions. Our first question is, what is Eid ul Adha? When is it celebrated? Answer is, Eid ul Adha means the festival of sacrifice and marks the end of Hajj on the 10th day of the month of Zulhijjah. The second question is, what is the special feature of this Eid? Why do Muslims offer animal sacrifice on this occasion? So answer is, the special feature of Eid is the sacrifice of an animal in the memory of the twin sacrifice offered by Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam. So Muslims offer animal sacrifice on this occasion. The third question is, into how many portions is the meat of the sacrificed animals divided? To whom is it given? So answer is, the animal which is usually a goat or a sheep is sacrificed for Allah alone and is divided into three portions. One is kept for the family itself, the other is given to relatives, neighbors, friends, and the third to poor and the needy. The fourth question is, can this meat be offered to the non-Muslims? So, answer is, yes, it can be offered to the non-Muslims, but for the poor and the needy only. The fifth question is, write a paragraph on how Eid al-Adha is celebrated. So, answer is, Eid al-Adha is a festival of sacrifice and marks the end of Hajj. Its special feature is the sacrifice of an animal. Animals like sheep, goat and cow is sacrificed for the Allah alone and is divided into three portions. One is kept for the family itself, the other is given to relatives, neighbors, friends, and the third to the poor and the needy, not necessarily Muslims. Alhamdulillah children, we have successfully completed the chapter 11 of Islamic Studies. Okay children, this is enough for this session. Inshallah, we will start our 12th lesson in next session. Till then, you must complete your total homework and send to us on WhatsApp. Keep going well with your studies. Till then, Allah Hafiz.